Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain the pool. This film tells the story of a man who is trapped in an abandoned swimming pool with a hungry crocodile. Can he survive the crocodile attack? Let's find out in the pool. The pool begins by showing a man who has just woken up from a faint and lies weakly at the bottom of a swimming pool whose water has been drained out. The man felt pain in his head and saw that his hand was injured and bleeding. But not only that, what was even more terrifying was that his feet were in the mouth of a crocodile. Suddenly, the man immediately got up so that the crocodile would not pounce on his leg. What will happen to the man next? The scene then switches by showing flashbacks a few days before the horrific incident that happened to the man in the swimming pool. The man's name is Day. Day is a production house crew whose job is to arrange equipment and preparations before filming in a swimming pool in an abandoned building. That night, Day was assigned by his superiors to inspect and repair the lighting around the pool. While Day is at work, Day's girlfriend, Koi, comes to the set with his pet dog, Lucky. Day was seen injecting something into his stomach when Koi was about to hug him from behind. Koi then gave an egg-shaped music box in which there was a tiny baby doll decoration as a birthday present for him. The man then wondered and thought his girlfriend was pregnant, but Koi assures that she is not pregnant. The next day, Day was seen relaxing in a 6-meter-deep swimming pool which at that time had not been drained of water. He then played ball with his dog. Just as Lucky was about to chase the ball, the dog entered an area of the building that was littered with leaves and dry twigs. Among the leaves, there are newspaper sheets about the great flood that caused the crocodiles in the zoo to run away and roam. One of Day's friends, who was getting ready to go home, found Lucky lost in the engine room. The man took Lucky near the swimming pool and tied the chain to an iron fence. He then told Day that he had drained the pool water and told him to get out of the pool before the water receded quickly. The man also found Day's insulin injection and placed it on the table by the pool. He warns Day not to carelessly save the insulin injection because it is very important in his life. They then joke around and Day asks his friend to buy him a pizza. But instead, he teased Day by throwing a roll of duct tape into the swimming pool and immediately left because he had to catch a plane. In the afternoon, Day, who had fallen asleep on a rubber boat, finally woke up after Lucky was barking non-stop. Day, who realized that the water in the swimming pool had been drained by half, immediately tried to climb to the pool's edge in various ways. He then saw the rope used to film the property and tried to reach his cell phone using the rope, but his attempt failed and he was screaming for help. Not long after, Day heard the sound of the cell phone vibrating, which indicated that someone was calling him. It turned out that the caller was Koi. Because his cell phone vibrated, he then waited by the side of the pool near the table to catch his cell phone, which was about to fall. But at the same time, Lucky kept barking and moving to the edge of the pool, until he almost fell into the pool. Day chooses to save Lucky and lets his phone fall into the water. Lucky managed to climb to the edge of the pool after Day helped him onto the rubber boat. It turned out that Day's phone was still hanging by the side of the pool thanks to the charger cable. But still, that didn't last long, and when he swam there, his phone kept falling into the water. Day then tried to plug the drain hole using his clothes. Unfortunately, the chain on his pants got caught in the iron cover of the drain. Yet at the same time, a pizza delivery man came to the pool. But because Day was still struggling to get the chain off the drain, he couldn't ask the pizza delivery guy for help, who left after leaving his pizza by the pool. Day finally gave up, and because he was too tired to try various ways to get out of the pool, he chose to rest on an inflatable boat and fell asleep again. In the afternoon, Koi comes to the pool to meet him. Seeing his boyfriend sleeping on an inflatable boat, Koi intends to surprise him by jumping into the swimming pool from above the jump, not realizing that the water level in the pool has dropped drastically. Day woke up by Lucky barking loudly, immediately startled, and tried to warn Koi not to jump, but she was shocked and ended up slipping on the jump and falling into the swimming pool. Koi's head accidentally hit the jumping foot, causing her head to bleed and she was unconscious. Day immediately laid Koi on a rubber boat. After that, he opened the blockage in the waterway so that the water in the pool receded quickly. On the other hand, Lucky didn't stop barking when he saw a crocodile crawling from the basement. Day tried to tell Lucky to be quiet so the crocodile wouldn't come to the dog, but Lucky kept barking, and when the crocodile got closer to Lucky, it slipped and fell into the swimming pool. Day couldn't help but have to stay up all night because the crocodile was now in the same pool. The next day, the water in the swimming pool was completely drained, but there is no movement from the crocodile. It looks like the crocodile wasn't hungry yet, so he didn't attack Day and Koi. Day accidentally finds a pregnancy test kit in Koi's trouser pocket. It turns out that yesterday Koi intended to tell the news of her pregnancy to him. Day then realized that the wound on Koi's head had to be bandaged or the bleeding would worsen. After searching for the remaining items in the pool, Day finally decided to use the duct tape his friend threw. However, the roll of duct tape was in the mouth of the sleeping crocodile. Slowly, he crept closer to the crocodile to get the duct tape. When there were only a few steps and he was about to take the roll of duct tape, Lucky suddenly barked and the crocodile woke up. But luckily, they managed to take the duct tape and treat Koi's wound. Day then took the initiative to open the waterway's cover and intended to go in there to find a way out. But when he said goodbye to Koi, the crocodile had already entered the waterway. Even so, he still ventured into there looking for a way out. Day and the crocodile turned out to be in different ways. Day then searched the waterways looking for a way out. When he reached the end of the drain, he found that the lid was locked and he finally decided to come back. Day then saw the crocodile had returned to the pool and was about to go to the Koi who was still unconscious. Day immediately rushed back to the pool to save Koi, just before the crocodile pounced on his girlfriend. He swiftly grabbed the crocodile's tail and pulled it away from the Koi. The next minute, Koi finally came to her senses and was still in pain from the wound on her head. Day, who was previously reluctant to have children, is now terrified of losing Koi and their baby in the womb. In the evening, Day and Koi began to feel hungry. Luckily, they have Lucky who is smart and understanding enough to drop the pizza into the pool so they don't starve. Day made a signal for help at the bottom of the pool on the third day using duct tape, hoping someone would see it and help them. Day and Koi had almost given up and began to feel weak due to lack of food and drink intake while stranded in the swimming pool. That night, they realized that the crocodile was a pregnant female crocodile and ended up laying eggs in the swimming pool. Day and Koi devised a strategy to trap the crocodile into the waterway on the fourth day by covering the drain hole with a cloth. Day pretended to be unconscious to get the crocodile to approach him. His trick worked. The crocodile got caught in the drain and they immediately closed the drain with a metal cover, then put a sofa on it. After that, they boiled the crocodile's eggs to eat. That night, Day confessed that at first he did not want to have children and intended to tell Koi to have an abortion if she got pregnant. Koi immediately got angry at him and cried because he was so cruel to her and his future child. But Day immediately apologized and regretted ever thinking that way. Finally, they promised to continue to survive for the sake of the prospective baby. They decided to take the crocodile out of the waterways on the fifth day and go in there. They also planned to hide in the way that Day found a few days ago. But Day is already very weak because he hasn't injected insulin into his body since the last night of the shoot. He then remembered that his friend had put an insulin injection on the table. But when he was about to take it, the insulin injection fell and broke. Day, who had resigned himself to his fate, then remembered that his cigarette box had fallen into a ditch a few days ago. Inside the cigarette case, there is an insulin injection as well. After searching, he finally managed to find his cigarette case and inject insulin into his body. His condition gradually recovered. The sixth day arrived. Day intends to return to the pool and tell Koi to stay hidden in the waterways to avoid the crocodile. While in the pool, he notices rusty razor wire sticking out over the pool. Day was desperate to climb up using the razor wire, ignoring the sharp wires that slashed his hand. But just as he was about to reach the edge of the pool, he slipped and fell into the pool and passed out. It turns out that this incident is shown at the beginning of the film. After surviving the crocodile's attack, Day immediately went into the waterways to hide. While hiding, he saw a branch of a waterway that was leading somewhere. After being traced, it turns out that the branch of the waterways only leads to the swimming pool next door. He then felt increasingly frustrated. The seventh day arrived. Day, who chose to stay hidden in the waterways, suddenly woke up and heard the sound of people above the swimming pool. It turned out that two men came to the pool to get something there and went down to the pool using a wooden ladder tied to an iron pipe. Because Day was in the drain and needed time to get back to the pool, he couldn't ask them for help. It started to rain and yet another chance to get out of the pool was missed and he had to think of another way. It turned out that the wooden ladder used by the two men was still in place. Day rushed to climb to the edge of the pool using the stairs, but again the crocodile blocked his steps. He struggled against the crocodile who became very aggressive because it had not eaten for days. When Day fought the crocodile in the pouring rain, the iron pipe that anchored the wooden ladder suddenly shifted from its place and made the wooden ladder continue to be dragged up to the edge of the pool. Day was feeling lost and frustrated because now the only hope of getting out of the pool had vanished. He sat limp and did not care anymore about his fate, which might become the crocodile's meal. However, in the last seconds before handing over his fate to the crocodile, he again remembers Koi and their baby to be struggling in a sewer that began to fill with water due to heavy rains. Koi tried to call for Day, but she almost drowned because the water had filled the ways where she was hiding. Koi then blew the whistle for help, but it was the dog whistle that Day used to train Lucky. Day immediately rose from adversity and fought with the crocodile to the last drop of blood. Day managed to block the crocodile's snout so it wouldn't pounce on him, then shouted at Lucky not to jump on him. But Lucky kept barking, as Koi kept blowing her whistle. But Day's efforts were in vain, because Lucky ended up jumping and because his neck was still tied with the chain necklace, he suffocated and died. Day was screaming hysterically, crying over the death of his beloved dog. He then vented his anger on the crocodile and killed it mercilessly. After that, he is forced and overcome with guilt, climbs up to the top of the swimming pool using Lucky's body. After that, Day tried to open the cover of the drain hole where Koi was hiding. After successfully opening it, it turned out that Koi had passed out from out of breath. Day then gave artificial respiration to save his girlfriend's life, but Koi still showed no signs of life. Day keeps trying and hoping that Koi doesn't leave him like Lucky, until finally Koi wakes up and they both finally survive. The film ends.